the earth and every living thing on it? Well, he did, and today I'm going to tell you about it. A long, long time ago, before there was anything, God made outer space and put the earth in it. The earth didn't look like it does now. Everything was very dark, and there was nothing but water everywhere. God said, "Let there be light." And just like that, there was light. God liked the light and called it day. He liked the dark, too, and called it night. That was the end of the first day. The next day, God made the sky. He made it out of some of the water that covered the earth. That was a pretty big job, but it was finished by the end of that day. On the next day, God told the dry land to appear out of the water. He called the dry land earth. He also made the water run off the land into big pools and called them seas. Then God said, "Let there be plants and flowers and trees of every kind," and there were. God liked the earth, seas, and plants he had made. That ended the third day. The fourth day began by God making the sun. He said it would be the light for daytime. He also made the moon and stars for nighttime. Then he put them all in the sky. Since there were a lot of stars, it took a whole day to finish making the lights in the sky. God liked them too. The next day, God began to make the living creatures of the earth. He made the fish and the birds. He made the great big whales and the tiny little shrimps. When God saw all the creatures he had made, he was glad. Then he told the birds to lay eggs and have baby birds, and the fish to have baby fish. In fact, he told everything he had made to have babies so that they could fill the seas and the skies. That day was a very busy one, wasn't it? But God wasn't finished yet. The sixth day came, and God made the animals. Dogs and cats and snakes and bugs and elephants and lions and monkeys and, well, just every animal in the whole world. He liked them all, but he still had one more creature to make. Can you guess what it was? It was people. God said, "Let's make man like us," and he did. Then God looked around at everything he had made, the light and dark, the sky, the land and seas, the plants and flowers and trees, the sun, moon, and stars, the birds and fish, the animals, and man. And when he saw the whole creation, he decided that it was very good. So, on the seventh day, the very last day of the very first week, God rested. And he liked that too.
Genesis. First one. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Day one, he made the light. Darkness did abound. He called it day, and by the way, the earth was spinning round. Day two, he made the waters. Hints enough to laugh. I
God created the heavens.